The Math Center presents Operations with Radicals. In this presentation, we'll talk about adding square roots, product and quotient rules, and operations with radicals. To add or subtract two radicals with the same radicand, you will add or subtract their coefficients. The answer then will be the sum or difference of the coefficients multiplied by the common radical. Let's take a look at an example. We have 3 square root of 5 plus 6 square root of 5. See that we have the same radicand, the square root of 5. Now take the coefficients 3 and 6, add them to get 9. Your answer is 9 square root of 5. Here's another example. We have 8 square roots of 3 minus the square root of 12. We see that right now they don't have the same radicand, so we can't just combine the coefficients. Notice that the square root of 12 is not in simplified form. We could write 12 as the product of 4 times 3. Notice that 4 is a perfect square. If you can find a factor of a number that's a perfect square, you can then take the square root of it and move it out of the radical. The square root of 4 is a whole number 2. So the square root of 4 times the square root of 3 is the same as 2 times the square root of 3. The square root of 3 must stay because it cannot be simplified. And now both numbers have a square root of 3 in them, so they can be combined. Take the coefficients 8 and 2, and you have 8 minus 2 is 6, so you're left with 6 square roots of 3. Next, we'll look at multiplying radicals. To multiply two radicals, you can move the multiplication under the same radical symbol, then do the multiplication. Make sure you simplify your answer. Let's do some examples. If you have the square root of 5 multiplied by the square root of 20, you can move the multiplication inside one radical. So this becomes the square root of 5 times 20, which is the square root of 100. Since I know the square root of 100 is 10, my final answer is 10. Next, we'll multiply the square root of 7 times the square root of 21. We can move the multiplication under one radical, and this becomes the square root of 7 times 21, or the square root of 147. We now have to look to see if we can simplify this answer. We would like to break down the square root of 147 as the product of a perfect square and another factor. After some checking, I can see that 49 is a perfect square and it can be brought out of the radical. Thus, our final answer is 7 square roots of 3. We can apply the quotient rule when dividing radicals. It tells us that the square root of A divided by the square root of B is the same as the square root of A divided by B. In other words, if you divide one radical by another, you can move the division under a single radical symbol. Again, when you get your answer, make sure you put it in simplest form. To divide the square root of 24 by the square root of 6, you can rewrite it as a single radical, the square root of 24 divided by 6. Under the radical, you have 24 divided by 6, which is 4. Therefore, the square root of 24 over 6 is equal to the square root of 4. 4 is a perfect square, so the square root of 4 equals 2. That's the final answer. Let's do another example. Say you have the square root of 100 divided by the square root of 2. You can rewrite that as the square root of 100 divided by 2. 100 divided by 2 equals 50. So you have the square root of 50. We need to make sure that this is in simplest form. Can we factor 50 into a product of a perfect square? Yes, 50 is 25 times 2, and 25 is a perfect square. So we can rewrite this as the square root of 25 times 2, and the 5 can be then brought out from underneath the radical, and you're left with 5 times the square root of 2. Another common operation on radicals is rationalizing the denominator. We say that a denominator is rationalized when it has no radical expression in the denominator. To rationalize the denominator, we multiply both the top and the bottom by a number that will give you a perfect square on the bottom. Here is an example. Let's say we have the square root of 3 divided by the square root of 5. If we want to remove the radical from the bottom of this fraction, we will have to rationalize the denominator. The trick to removing that square root of 5 on the bottom is to multiply both the top and the bottom by the square root of 5. In my numerator, I have the square root of 3 times the square root of 5, which equals the square root of 15. In my denominator, I have the square root of 5 times the square root of 5, which equals the square root of 25. 25 is a perfect square, so the square root of 25 is just 5. In the numerator, the square root of 15 can't be broken down into another perfect square. And in the denominator, the square root of 25 equals 5. So our final answer is the square root of 15 divided by 5. Thank you for watching this presentation on operations with radicals.